I spent 2 years working on a tool for creating and editing maps. 1,400 commits later and 1,000 issues and a bootstrap business that didn't quite work out. But today I'm releasing the entire thing for free as open source software. I'm not sure exactly what will become of it, but the whole thing is going open source. The Next.js app, the billing, the map editing, everything. So this is a video to introduce the open source version of Placemark and show you what's inside. A little about myself. My name is Tom McWright. I started my career at Mapbox working on open source tools for mapping, as well as Mapbox Studio, our design tool. Then I went to Observable to work on visualization tools, Config to work on CAD tools, and then I bootstrapped Placemark as a mapping company for 2 years. Now I'm at Valtown, working on tools for developers to write APIs, cron jobs, and much more in TypeScript in the browser with zero configuration. Here's what Placemark can do. Placemark is kind of like Figma for geospatial data. You can create an account, log in, and then either import existing geospatial data, which comes in many, many formats like GeoJSON, KML, shapefiles, or you can create it from scratch by drawing on the map. It also supports a lot of operations on that data, like buffering or creating the centroid of a polygon. And much like Figma, there's real-time collaboration between multiple people working on the map. Now, by no means is this a perfect or bug-free application. It's actually pretty complex, and there are lots of things that I would love to improve about it. But I think that there are some really interesting and useful things in the open source product. For example, there's a framework on top of Mapbox GL that supports selecting and editing multiple shapes at a time. There are many map operations that have been simplified so that people can trigger them via the user interface. And there are many formats that are supported for import and export. And when those importers and exports have issues, it actually reports the errors back to users in pretty useful ways. The real-time aspect of Placemark is also pretty interesting. It uses replicache as well as server-sent events in order to sync multiple clients at the same time and show real-time updates to the map. So what does it really mean for Placemark to be going open source? Well, it means that the application at placemark.io will no longer run. Basically, you had to pay to use it, and it cost me money to run. I'm not running that business anymore. But what you can do is install all the software on your own server. You can create your own product based on it, even. Or you can pull some of those open source parts into modules, or even use them to improve your own applications. This is all because I'm using a pretty liberal open source license for the product, called the MIT license. And I do want to note that I'm still developing Figma plugins under the same name, Placemark. So far, I've created the Placemark plugin, which allows you to create street-level vector maps, as well as Placemark Globe, which allows you to create vector globes. Those projects are just continuing indefinitely. They're kind of fun for me to work on, and they're both open source as well as available on the Figma store. So I would recommend checking them out.